It's Captain America. So Black Widow told that Captain America was talking, that Spider-Man was talking smack about Captain America. But Black Widow told Spider-Man that Captain America was talking smack about him.
And it's not like the bombing is happening constantly. It's not like the attacks are happening all the time, but it's enough to instill fear in the population.
But they said they didn't want to stay there. They wanted to leave very quickly because they were afraid of what might happen. It seems like it's that not knowing, and the eeriness of not exactly knowing where the Russian forces are. Just in terms of the bonds between people here and the resilience of such an everyday word now, but the determination that so many people here have, not just in for the immediate, but seemingly the determination that may last them a very long time.
On Spider-Man, you have gold dust. This is something now you never get far. If you don't listen, you're gonna get far too. It's dark. Turn that screen up to left. This one got to be right. Because it was flapping. Oh my. It got some. You should have been dead 165 years ago. It's my turn now. Why should I leave you? You can't even make the smallest pencil in the whole world. That makes no sense. But you look like a sharpener. I'm not sharpening my pencil hole.
Listen,
Spider-Man. You ain't got no more to get out of Mars. Actually, you should really go back to Mars. Okay, you wanna bring people around? Here's my cute little brother. Spitting. Look at y'all. Me and my bro got this. Look at you. Two Captain Americas? Oh, that's lame. That's why we both get the girls more than you. He got a girl and I got a girl. Her name is Will Rocket. We both got a bird. I got explosion. She can flip people. Oh, I forgot. You guys are eagles. And you don't crap. You should get slapped across the mind. I don't look like an eraser, you look like this. You have to draw an eraser like this?